At the very beginning, I think probably about 3 or 4 times a week, sometimes we'd play small venues in Sheffield. We played the Red House loads of times, the Harley, just an unimaginable amount of times. And a lot of the gigs were horrible. Like, a lot of times we were just an awful, awful, shit university band.
Small venues have recently found themselves increasingly under threat in Sheffield. The Boardwalk has fell on hard times, the Grapes has stopped being a live venue, and Leadmill has had to rely on student club nights more and more as a source of income. We asked a few figures in the music industry for their opinion why small venues have become under threat.
I'm a singer. We're from Oldham, Greater Manchester. I've played in small venues for years, and I love playing in big venues, and I've played in big venues, but there's something great about the intimacy, and especially when you start selling out small venues, I mean the crowd close up to you, and at that intimacy, you can't beat it, and you don't get that in big places. But I mean, on your way up, when you start a band, you know, you can't just go and play, and you can't get on a support tour with a big band straight away, so you need to play in these small places, and it's important that we have them around the cities. You know, just so bands, you know, get the opportunity to play. It'd be a shame for them to, you know, start shutting down, because people, you know, people who actually go and watch bands, they like to go and see bands in small places. They like to see them being close to the band, so it's important that.
Is kind of the foundation for people not only getting started in music, but people coming up. So they're essential. For example, Arctic Monkeys didn't just headline Glastonbury overnight. They should know that.
Toddler T, the skanky skanky prince of Sheffield, started DJing at age of 14 in small clubs and bars across Steel City. By the age of 16, he'd left school to pursue a full-time career in music. We asked him his opinions on small venues and where he'd be without them.
And also, on top of that as well, with the music scene, it's that not everyone suits big venues. Not every type of music is suited to that environment. So even if you're not up and coming and you're established, you know what I mean, you might be more set in a place that's 200 capacity rather than 2,000. Well, I think, like I said before, without them, then you don't even get started going performing live or DJing live or singing live or telling jokes live or whatever you do live. So you do need them as a platform to get A to B. It's just normal. But I don't even think, if they weren't there in Sheffield, yeah, it'd be a struggle. If they weren't there in Leeds, I would never play in Leeds. If they weren't there in London, I would never play in London. If they weren't there in Japan, where I just come from, I wouldn't be playing in Japan. So it goes without saying for the rest of the world, but in Sheffield, for me particularly coming up there, then obviously it was mad important that they were on my doorstep. Practice and deal with it and grab your fan base all the way till you get to performing at Glastonbury or whatever it is you see as big. You need that, and you need to be on your doorstep, because you're not going to get bookings out of town straight away, because one, you haven't got a fan base necessarily, and two, you don't know people in Scunthorpe or Brighton or wherever it is that you end up getting booked after you've built up a team. So you definitely need them on your doorstep, because they're the foundation and the first step of the journey.
Honestly, I think 12 venues struggling because the bands that go down well in small venues don't seem to be getting much hype, and I think the bands that are getting a lot of hype don't really seem to sell tickets. So these bands that are getting loads of hype don't actually sell tickets, so they don't sell out these small venues, so all these bands that are about, I don't seem to be bringing the custom, maybe, I don't know, or their fans don't seem to drink beer or something.
Small venues provide a real great training ground for bands to work on their art before they can take it out to the wider world.
Thomas Truax at the Grapes upstairs, this guy makes his own instruments, and it was brilliant, it was really good fun, and it's the sort of thing that you just would never see in anywhere else apart from a smaller venue, would you? Mm. Never see that in like an O2 Academy or...
I think it's something to do with the fact that a lot of music venues are now nationally organised, so I suppose things like the O2 Academies and that kind of thing, they've got rooms of every size, and bands can play at each and every single one, and it's really easy and kind of like straightforward. You don't have to worry about different rooms and different like speaker systems and that kind of thing. So from a playing point of view, I think that's probably one of the reasons.
Overall, it's clear that small venues are incredibly important for the music industry. From being the starting ground for many up-and-coming bands to being somewhere to expect the extraordinary. It's clear we'll always need these places across the country.
I stepped into an avalanche. It covered up my soul. When I am not this hunchback that you see.